I hope your day is full of broomsticks and crowns. That's all I have. And pink and green. It's a wicked intro, motherfuckers. I haven't seen it yet, but Gabby Lamb, our guest, has, and she's a big fan. And so I trust her opinion. Guys, go see Wicked. What's up, everyone? It is I, Shank, reporting live from the Comedy Store for another episode of Shank Podcast with the one, the only comedian, Gabby Lamb. But before we get into this week's episode of Shank with Gabby Lamb, there's just a few things I want to tell you about. One, this bitch and friends show coming to the 12th. Of December, 12-12, Comedy Store, main room. Get tickets. 8 p.m. show. It will sell out. It's a fire lineup. It's me, Kim Congdon, Jordan Jensen, Whitney Cummings, Ian Fidance, Josh Potter. Get tickets now, sooner rather than later. They're on the Comedy Store website, and they're in the link in my bio on my Instagram, at Princess Shank on Instagram. As always, you can find me here every Wednesday on Shank and every Monday on This Bitch Podcast and patreon.com/SarahWineChank for bonus content. But before we get into this week's episode of Shank with Gabby Lamb, I just want to tell you about one thing, and that's Oh Yeah socks. Oh yeah. If you're like me, you love putting on socks, and socks, they change your mood. I sleep in socks. I'm a sleep socker. Not everyone is, but I'm a proud sleep with socks person. I'm a sleep socker till the day I die. When I put on my socks before bed, I love to put on my Oh Yeah socks because they are so fun. There's ones with French fries. There's ones with hamburgers. There's ones with alligators. They have the slippers that are made that look like flamingos. They make amazing gifts, and they have every type of category of sock that you could ever want. So you can personalize the socks for the person you're giving your gift choose interest. So if you are getting a gift for someone who's obsessed with soccer, I'm sure you could find soccer balls. They have everything you could ever want. And it's a great way to support the podcast. They make amazing stocking stuffers. I give them all the time. Shop ohyeah.com. That's 3 O's H-Y-E-A-H.com. Discount code Sarah, S-A-R-A 10 for 10% off unique sock designs. And let's do it. Let's get into this week's episode of Shank with the one, the only Gabby Lamb. Guys, here it is. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Shank. I'm Sarah Wineshank, and today's guest is the one, the only, comedian Gabby Lamb.
So nice to be back.
The return of the Gabby Lamb.
It's just so nice.
It is. It's a very seasonal time right now.
It is. I like that I do like a monthly appearance. I start getting, I've realized that I'm like codependent with you now. I'm always like, when am I going to do it again?
Really?
Because yeah.
I was like, do I ask her again, or is it like kind of too soon?
No, I
literally. That's so funny.
It's so, bitch, I think I'm more like once a month, I'm like, I wonder if I'll get it this month.
That's so funny. Yeah, because I was like, that. Do I ask Gabby again? Or is she gonna be sick of me?
No, I literally love it.
I love it too.
I love it. And we have you on, I think, next
tea
month.
Tea time.
Yeah,
next month. I'm excited to do tea time because I love having Harper on too. You guys are so funny. Separate, together.
It'll be cute.
All of the things.
It'll be cute.
All right, so what's going on? Right now, it's November. Technically, when this comes out, Thanksgiving will have already happened.
It will have. Okay.
What are you doing for Thanksgiving?
I'm going to a steakhouse with my Whoa. Boyfriend's dad.
That's kind of fun.
It should be cute.
That's fun.
It's honestly more fun than going to
your family.
My actual family's, yeah.
Is your family disappointed you're not going?
No, they don't. It's like they're so not traditional, but it's my mom is going to my uncle's and love, you know, I do love my family.
Yes.
Love is a thing that I have for my family.
Yes.
Do I want to spend Thanksgiving with them? No. No, it's not going to.
It's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen. So.
Do you have a brother, right?
I have two.
You have two? Are they going down for Thanksgiving?
So they have different moms.
Okay.
And they are going to be doing their absolute, they have like their own lives.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're going to a steakhouse with your boyfriend's dad. Have you met him before?
I have.
Okay.
Hot dad.
Whoa.
Hot dad. Dad has Riz.
Dad has Riz?
Dad has Riz. Yeah.
Is it a little overwhelming? Is that how hot dad is? Or is it?
I'm like, you know, and here's the thing. I love my boyfriend, but I go, why didn't you get your dad's Riz?
No.
Why didn't you get as much Riz as your dad has?
You can't get everything.
Can't get everything.
So you guys are going to go to a steakhouse? That's fun.
It'll be cute.
That is fun.
It'll be cute. What are you doing?
I'm going to my parents' house.
In OC?
No, they live in the Valley, in Encino. So
very close.
They said, This is the first year that my mom assigned me something to make.
Ew.
And I went, and then I realized I am 37 and I can make green beans. But when she gave me the assignment, at first I was like, are you sure you want me to make the green beans?
And you said, I'm a child.
I felt like that. I was like, I'm making the green beans. And then I was like, she's like, yeah, Sarah, it's not that hard. And I was like, can I make them in your oven? And she goes, I prefer that you didn't.
Are you serious? She asks you to bring. She asks you to make shit, and then says you can't make it in my house.
She said I couldn't make it in her oven, and I was like, because I have like a little like oven, like a portable oven, because I don't have an actual oven.
Are you still in Topanga?
No, I'm not in Topanga.
Okay,
I'm in the Valley.
Okay.
But my kitchen is like a little bigger than it was before, so I thought maybe she'd let me use her oven. Debbie did not want me using her oven, and then I felt like I was like, should I even be going to their Thanksgiving? Because my boyfriend went to Texas with his family and he invited me, but I've just been going, traveling so much.
You're always traveling and you're always in Texas.
I'm always in fucking Texas. Yeehaw, motherfuckers.
I know. It's just.
I know.
There's like two states that I really.
Can't with.
And it's Arizona and Texas.
Really?
Hate.
Have you been to Austin?
I have been to Austin.
You don't like it.
Gotta be honest.
Not for you.
Not for me.
That's how I felt about Washington, D.C. I went there for the first time.
Really? I like D.C.
I fucking hated it.
Did you do D.C. improv?
No. I did something else. The D.C. comedy loft.
Not fun?
It was interesting.
Real?
I didn't like the people of D.C.
Okay.
I felt like they were all loser dorks. Which is really mean to say.
The people of D.C. are loser dorks?
I know. Now I'm not going to be able to go back.
What made them loser dorks?
They just seemed like all they cared about was, like, politics. And they all had little glasses on. And they were all wearing, like, J. Crew and, like, L.L. Bean. And, like...
You are just so close to the White House.
And the White House was underwhelming. My first time seeing it, I thought I was going to be wowed. I wasn't.
It's crazy that the president, do they have to live there? No, they can live in their own houses, right?
No, I think they have to live there.
Ew, dude.
It's like, and it was a weird time to go to D.C. Like, I don't need to see where Trump's sleeping.
You don't need to see, well, technically, you know, Biden's still sleeping there.
Well,
but
who's really in there right
and
now?
And who is in there? And that's a good question.
I heard Kamala's on vacation, but wasn't she like the temporary president? And now she's on vacation. So like,
it's like, what's even
going
on?
Who's running the show?
Nobody. But has anybody been? You go,
No.
So, you know, at the end of the day, the White House sucks.
The White House sucks. The monuments are underwhelming. I didn't know who any of the people were.
It's like they're so old.
It's so old. I just didn't like D.C. It wasn't for me.
I liked D.C. I don't know why. I thought there was a lot of energy in it, and I liked it.
I felt there was not enough energy in it.
Interesting.
Like, I want the chaotic energy of New York.
It felt so chaotic to me, and I think what it was like this weird mixed energy of, like, people in politics, and then, like, D.C. people.
I don't think I saw the D.C. people. I think everyone who came to my show was, like, people in politics.
Yeah.
Because everyone was pretty much the same and like very mundane and kind of like soulless. Calling people soulless feels like really bad. Like,
I mean,
feel
so
like
many
calling
of them,
them
are.
Calling them ugly seems less mean than calling somebody soulless.
You think?
Well, I also called them ugly too. So yeah. I'm not going back to D.C. anytime soon.
Because everybody's ugly and soulless.
Because, well, no, my friend told me before I went there, she said, just so you know, they call D.C. the ugly version of Hollywood. I didn't know that.
I mean, I've never heard that. How? In what way?
Because everyone has power, but it has nothing to do with their appearance.
Whoa.
So they're all like.
Right. So it's where the uglies go.
It's where the uglies go to thrive and talk law.
Right, because the hots come here because they're like, we can be powerful with our hot looks.
And the smarts go to D.C. because they're like, well, we can wow them with our knowledge of the judicial system.
Right, because we'll never be hot enough to be starring as a lead. In any kind of rom-com.
And, I told them, I heard you guys were the ugly version of Hollywood. They didn't like that. But hear me out.
Yeah.
Because in most cities I go to, I can't walk a few steps without walking into a Botox clinic. They're everywhere.
Yeah.
There's none in D.C.
None in D.C.
They don't care.
They don't care. Yeah, they don't care. Because they say you're here to learn.
It's about this.
Yeah. We don't care about what's going on here. And I got to be honest.
Yeah.
I care about what's going on.
Me too, but have you watched The Substance?
No, I haven't fucking watched it yet, and I keep hearing about it. I got it. Yeah.
No, The Substance fucked me up.
Is
dude.
It about, like, I don't even know what it's about.
It's about Demi Moore has this, she's like, I'll give you a brief synopsis.
Please, yeah.
Okay, so she's like this aerobics instructor and she's been like, had this show for like years, right? And it's okay. kind of like a jazzercise, like aerobics thing. And she looks banging. She's like supposed to be 50, but in real life she's 62. Ugh. Her body looks amazing. Ugh. And she's in the bathroom and she hears the head of the network basically saying that she's too old to, and they need to replace her.
To be
her.
A Pilates?
To be like a Pilates like personality okay. on TV and oh, they need right. to replace okay. her. So around the same time, she goes to the doctor and the doctor offers her this injection that basically brings out another version of yourself.
Sign me up.
Yeah, that's what you think. That's what you think, Gabby. And then you leave being like, I'll just get, you leave the movie being like, I'll just get old.
Really?
Yeah, that's how powerful it is.
Really?
You will be like, holy fuck, dude. Like, I have goosebumps just thinking about it. It affected me so much. My boyfriend was affected, but not on the level that I was.
Yeah, well, probably because he's not a woman.
It was so crazy. And then it becomes like a horror movie because she has this new version of her that goes back and gets her old job. Wow. But every week she has to switch between her old body and her new body.
Wow.
So she... And, like, she starts misusing the substance that they give her to stay young. So it, like, backfires and she gets all, like, mutated. You gotta watch it.
Which, honestly, I mean, that is what starts happening.
No,
when
I
women
know.
Start getting too much work done, and then we start getting mutated.
Yeah.
That's
and
true.
And then by the end of it, she's, like, a shell of herself. And it gets so dark and it's so fucking crazy. I have not stopped thinking about it since. And then I'm, like, Demi Moore looks amazing, too.
Wow.
It was amazing.
And you know that she's also still getting so much work done.
She's getting so much work, but she's getting the good work.
She's getting the work. She's getting the good work. I know. And that's the thing.
She's got the money.
Yeah. When you have the money, you can get the good work.
I know. But you know who else we saw a big change in? Lindsay Lohan.
Oh my God. She looks so good.
What's going on with her?
Don't know what's going on.
Do you think she got a facelift?
Something. I mean, maybe she got, we were just talking about before we started rolling.
Yeah.
The shit that we've been getting.
Sculptra.
Maybe she got some Sculptra.
Sculptra, because it's more natural than looking than filler. Because it helps you produce collagen.
I was told that, because I just got Radius.
Yeah.
I was told that it does a similar thing, but Sculptra seems to be a little bit more natural.
Yeah, and Sculptra takes longer to generate. Like, you get Radius and you leave with your lines filled.
And that's true.
And with Sculptra, it takes like 4 to 6 weeks to start seeing collagen production.
And we do need collagen.
And we do need collagen. And also Sculptra, they recommend doing like a few vials of it. Like
and that's
every,
what turns me off from it. I go, I don't want to spend this much money.
It's expensive.
But then that's what is the good stuff.
And then, but the thing that's fucked up about it, you put it in your face and then you have to massage it so you don't get lumps in your face.
Yes, you don't get lumps.
And it's so painful. Like, that part grosses me out.
Yeah, the massaging the shit is, it is gross.
And it feels
and feeling
so
it,
gross.
It does feel gross.
And when they inject it, it feels so gross. Like, filler is my least favorite thing to get.
It does feel gross.
It feels like you're, like, when the needle goes in, oh.
I know. I just got on, I got my lips dissolved.
Does
I
did that my, hurt?
Very. Very much.
How do they do that? They just put in a needle and suck it out?
It's a product called Hylenex, which is an enzyme that breaks down filler. So they just inject it into your lips or wherever the fuck you have filler. I had my lips.
Yeah.
And it just breaks it all down over the course of a couple of days.
And do you have to rub it?
You have to massage it.
Oh,
so
I don't like that.
I know. So my lips are a little
lumpy.
Uneven. No, it's not lumpy. It doesn't feel lumpy. It's just like tender.
Yeah.
But I could still like, I got the first round dissolved last week.
Uh-huh.
And a bitch, there was some, I mean, it's just like, I have so many years of filler in my lips. So it just takes.
Which is so expensive.
Which is just so expensive. And the reason I keep getting botched lips is because nobody ever fully fucking dissolves it. And then I'll like get one round of dissolver and I'm like, okay, I don't like it. Like I want to have my lips done again. So then I refill before.
It's too soon?
When it's too soon. And so I end up having overfilled botched lips again. So today I was like, just get rid of everything. We need to start so clean.
Okay. So do you trust this injector?
I do.
How do you know that you trust the injector?
I trust the injector because my friend went to him.
Okay.
And he came highly recommended. And my old injector, who I did love, who's currently not working, worked with him. And she's like, he's great.
Okay.
So
because you never know. It's all up to chance.
It is all up to chance. You're
You sit down and you're like, I'm trusting you with my fucking face.
With my damn face. But the great thing, again, about filler is that you can just get it dissolved. It's not like, and this is why I don't want to get any kind of, like, I don't want to get my tits done, any of that, because it's so easy for surgeries to go wrong. Can you imagine spending like $20,000 on your tits and then having them look fucking botched? Because it sucks. And
dude, like, how sick. If my tits came out botched.
Oh my God, one of my friends got her tits done.
What'd they do?
Botched as fuck.
Does she know that they're botched?
I don't know. I think that she's like in denial because she spent so much money on them.
What's wrong with them?
Okay. Lee, are you in here?
Lee's not in here.
Lee's not in here. I remember I showed him the tits. And okay. So she needed reconstructive surgery, which she didn't get.
Okay.
And she was just like, just fill them up. You know, just fill the tits up. Okay. And the problem was that her nipples were pointing downwards.
Okay.
So then she gets her tits done, doesn't get the reconstructive surgery to put the nipples up.
So then they're down?
So then the tits are just all weird and big, and the nipples are pointing down. And they're all, like, far apart, and it's just, you know, if you're going to spend that money, you got to do it. Right.
I read about this. I was looking up this Yelp review for this plastic surgeon, and they said this woman, she went to get B's put in, and the plastic surgeon put D's in.
Now that's something.
See,
that's what, and like, what the fuck?
Dude, how do you fuck that up?
How do you do that? It's just.
And then now you're looking like a porn star when you just want to look like a nice, natural lady.
And that's the thing. If I got my tits done, I would just want like a little bit, because they're like, I have very flat tits, and it's just, I would just want them a little bit. Just maybe a B. Yeah, a B.
I left watching this movie, The Substance, being like, it's fine to get old.
That is also true.
And that was the message of the movie. And it was like, whoa. It was kind of like, be careful what you wish for.
Right.
Because she kept chasing this fucking dragon. And it's like a drug, dude.
It is a drug.
And it's like, it's a fine line between looking normal and looking fucking insane.
And we do, like, you know, I don't know if we've talked about it on here before, but it's so easy to cross into, like, body dysmorphia. Because when I was getting... when my lips were really, really overblown, you start, like, it's like you can't really see it anymore. Yeah. And you have an idea in your head of what you want things to look like. So you're like, well, maybe if I just get a little more, it will finally, I'll get the look that I want. But so that you just, like, keep going, and it doesn't ever get to what you want because you have this idea and you think if you keep going, you're going to get there.
And it's fucking expensive.
Bitch, it's so expensive.
It's so expensive.
I will say, like, I love Botox. I will never, and I think, I mean, and what it all comes down to, too, I think with getting work done is, like, the skincare stuff. It's like, if you're going to do it, do, like, the PRP, do this stuff that, like, produces collagen.
Yeah.
Like.
Microneedling,
lasers, because, like, I have so much, you know, discoloration. The lasers are great. Peels are great. Like, you can do a lot of stuff without actually having to, like, get injectables.
Yeah.
I also just want, I would like a little bit of a bigger lip. And can we blame society?
Yes, we can. We can blame society. So question.
Yeah.
Are you farting in front of your boyfriend yet?
Constantly.
Okay, so what happened to get to this point?
It just, I got to a point where I was like, I can't hold back anymore.
I knew that you were going to get there. Do you shit in front of him?
I do. He doesn't love that. Believe it or not.
He doesn't?
Like, I'll leave the door open and he'll be like, can you please close the door? And I'm like, are you a pussy? Are you a pussy? But I do. I do be shitting.
You do be shitting.
Yeah. The other day. Oh, God. Here's the thing. The other day, I held my poop in for too long.
Yeah.
Because I went to see Wicked.
Was it good?
It's like, I mean, you go... I can't even, words escape me.
That's how good it is?
It's just so good.
Have you seen the musical?
So many times.
And you like this more?
I mean, they're different. They're musical theater. Theater is just such an experience because it's live.
Yeah.
So I love them both equally.
Okay.
For a cinematic experience, I mean, blows shit out of the water.
Really?
I mean, just so fucking good.
Okay.
Did you ever see the musical?
Yeah, I saw the musical.
Did you like it?
I loved the musical.
It's so fucking good.
Okay, I want to see it, but I've just been turned off of it because Ariana Grande seems like she's losing her mind.
Okay, you're wrong for that.
What?
Ariana Grande can do no wrong ever in this world.
But the clips of her with...
So, okay, the clips
are... What's going on there?
So it's insane. But I will say, after I watched the movie, I was like, you know what? They can be as insane as they want.
Because it's that good?
Because it's that good. You go, there's something insane happened on set. I don't know what it is.
They're trauma bonded.
Those interviews are diabolical.
Can we pull up an interview?
They're so bad
where they're like touching each other and like
crying, and you go, well, this is why Trump won, you know? Yeah. Because of shit like this.
Yeah.
But I will say, after watching that movie, I was like, you know what? Fuck it. They are allowed.
This TV screen's not on. Oh. Can we get that on?
Yeah.
So wait, you had to shit during Wicked?
I had to shit during Wicked.
And you held it for too long.
I held it. I knew I was doing something wrong, but I was like, I can't get up to go shit. I mean, they popped their pussies so hard in this.
What do you mean?
They're so good. They're so talented. They popped their pussies so hard during this that whatever weird shit is going on now, you go, you guys broke your brains, and I can understand why.
look.
Seriously, this is one of my favorite interviews. I've been doing this for almost 20 years. This is one of my favorite interviews.
Her voice, it's like, what's going on?
Yeah, wait, go back.
I just want to say thank you.
Thank you very much.
Cynthia's a freak.
Really annoying if I ask for a picture with you.
No,
guys?
You're great.
The crying.
Every interview they do, they're crying.
It's insane.
But are they gay together?
Who knows? Who knows what's going on?
There's clips of them where they're touching each other. I'm like, they look like they're scissoring.
I mean, maybe spiritually they are. But I mean, bitch, that damn movie.
Okay, so.
It transformed them.
Yeah.
They became whatever the fuck they are as a result of this movie. And I'm like, go ahead.
I feel like she's not okay, though.
She's probably not.
Yeah. She's been through a lot.
And our girl's been through a lot.
Ariana?
Yeah.
I feel like she really has.
She has.
But you know what? She got cheated on by a theater kid, right?
What?
Wasn't the guy like...
No, you're messing it all up.
She left a guy.
He cheated on his wife.
To be with her.
Ethan Slater, yes.
To be with her husband now.
She's not married to him.
Oh.
And it seems like they're keeping the relationship very under wraps.
The Broadway guy.
Yes. SpongeBob. He played SpongeBob in SpongeBob the musical.
He played SpongeBob?
Yeah, that's like his whole lore. Such a bad musical.
Imagine you get with SpongeBob.
And she did.
And you're Glenda, bitch, and you're with SpongeBob. Level up.
She's with SpongeBob.
Level up, Ariana. Be with Cynthia.
Yeah, at least. But you know what? I saw the movie and I said, you know what? I get it.
He's got a SpongeBob face.
He's not cute.
He looks exactly like SpongeBob when he's in the outfit.
Yeah. And he's not cute, but she dates traditionally not cute guys.
She falls in love with the artist.
And that's what I love about her. I'm like, whatever, bitch. You're so, like, I don't know what's going on with you, but I'm here for it forever.
Yeah, okay, so I need to see it. Did your boyfriend see it with you?
He didn't see it with me.
Okay.
No, I went with my best friend because we love Wicked. So. Okay.
Did you dress up?
No, I didn't dress up.
Okay. If you were going to dress up, which one would you dress up
Probably Elphaba. I do love Elphaba.
That's the Wicked Witch.
Yes. Yeah.
That's their formal name. I like how you...
Her formal name is Elphaba. And the actress who plays her is Cynthia Erivo. So talented.
See, I'm going Glinda.
Yeah, you're Glinda. You're very much Glinda.
I'm wearing the crown.
Yeah, you're very Glinda. And I love Glinda.
Okay.
But Elphaba, she's like haunted. Like there's something powerfully haunted about her. Okay. Which I like.
So you loved it.
Loved it.
Okay.
But I held my poop in the whole time, right?
Okay. Because you didn't want to miss anything?
I didn't want to miss anything.
Okay.
And so they break the movie up into two parts. I don't know if you know that.
No.
I didn't know that.
Was there an intermission?
So they only release the first act. So the second act is going to be released in like 2026.
Oh, hell no.
So it ends at Defying Gravity. So we don't see the whole thing, but it's a 2.5 hour long fucking movie.
Wait. Yeah. They're really baiting us.
They already shot the full thing, but they're releasing it in parts. I know.
So we're going to see a lot more tears from Ariana.
Something weird's going to happen. And who knows?
They do seem like their relationship seems like that of like some people who have slept together to me.
I mean, even more so. Do you remember? It reminds me of like Jonestown energy. Like.
Yeah.
Like there's some kind of cult thing going on. They're like all weirdly fucking and like something weird happened.
Yeah.
But they deserve it.
They do.
I mean, can you even imagine being in like
Wicked?
I can't even imagine. It's just, and to be that talented, I'm like, you can do whatever you want forever.
Yeah. No, she is really talented.
She's so talented.
But
okay, so I held my poop in the whole movie.
Okay,
right?
So then what?
Back to that.
Okay.
So I'm like, this is gonna be bad for me. Okay.
But you just didn't, the movie was so good that you didn't want to shit?
Yeah, I didn't want to shit. So then
You don't like shitting it at the movie theaters?
I find a shit wherever, just not during Wicked. I could shit here if I needed to.
I could shit here, but I'd rather not.
I'd rather not.
Yeah, I'd rather not shit here at the Comedy Store.
Done it.
But if I had to make myself comfortable, I know exactly which bathroom I would shit in.
Oh,
the handicap one around the corner.
Wow.
Because it's just a solo stall. I could really get in there.
What if somebody with no legs needed that? And then you're in there blowing it up.
Well, since it's like 2 p.m, I feel like the amputees are not coming through right now. Maybe it would be a little less. It would be more insensitive if it was like 9 p.m.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's too close quarters in there.
They're so small.
It's like being like in a little locker.
It should be illegal how small the bathrooms are here.
No, I know.
It's such a painful experience. So I shit. I hold in my shit. I get to my boyfriend's. And you know when you hold your shit, and maybe you don't know this, but okay. I know this because I do this too often.
Yeah.
And it's probably the reason that I have hemorrhoids.
Okay.
I hold my shit into the point where then you can't shit because it's so stuck inside of you.
Yes. Okay. Been
right.
there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you have been there.
Yeah.
Right. So I get to my boyfriend's after Wicked and I'm in so much pain. Like,
so does he know you're in pain?
So I get, and I'm like, we were supposed to go out to dinner. I was like, baby, I can't go out to dinner. I'm in so much pain. He goes, oh my God, are you okay? And I said, gotta be honest, held my shit in the whole movie.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It's really backfiring.
Yeah.
I can hardly walk. So yeah. I'm like laying in bed, like, you know, breathing,
okay,
taking deep breaths. And he's like, maybe you should try to shit. And I said, I should. Yeah. But I'm in so much pain. So I go into his bathroom. And I managed to. But
congrats.
It wasn't good. Thank you.
Yeah.
But it wasn't good.
What do you mean it wasn't good?
It was like the poop was, it was hard. It came out in like, you know.
Clumps?
Like drops, like poop balls.
Yeah, yeah.
Wasn't like a good solid, you know.
Yeah.
It was as if it
the
was
consistency
bad.
Wasn't good.
And you know that, and I can feel
there's
it,
something
like,
underlying happening.
There's something underlying happening.
You're dehydrated.
I was dehydrated.
Okay.
I was. I just like a lot of things were happening. I didn't eat any vegetables. Well, I haven't been eating vegetables recently, so it's just
okay.
It was a bad mix.
Yeah.
And it annihilates my asshole. I get out of the bathroom. I look in the mirror and I'm like, well, there's some new hemorrhoids. Everything's bloody. I'm just like, this is a mess.
You're bleeding.
Bleeding.
Okay.
And I was supposed to have sex that night and I was like, it's just not happening.
Yeah.
It's just whatever's going on with my butthole, with my, it's just not happening.
Yeah.
So all of that to say, I did, you know, I had to walk him through that experience and I said, we're not having sex tonight. My asshole's mangled.
No.
I'm in pain.
My asshole's mangled.
Asshole's
so
mangled.
What did you guys do instead?
Watched a movie, went to bed.
What movie?
Strange Darling.
Was it good?
It's good.
What's Strange Darling?
It's interesting. It's
okay, tell me, try to open this fucking water bottle from the Comedy Store. Tell me if you can.
Now what the fuck is this?
I literally have to have my
Bitch,
boyfriend
what the
come
hell
over.
Is this?
I know. I have to have my boyfriend what come the? Over to open them for me all the time.
No.
I had 6 water bottles before
Please,
he left town.
Xavier.
I had to have him open them for
how
me.
How are we supposed to do that?
I don't know.
Delicate. No.
Our nothing will make me feel more feeble than that.
And this is why we need men. Sometimes yeah. I go, we don't need them. And then something like this happens. I go, never mind. I guess we need them.
Strange Darling.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing is what it seems when a twisted one-night stand spirals into a serial killer's vicious murder spree. Uh-uh.
So that's what we watched after I almost died shitting.
What a night.
What
Did
a
you
damn
have
night.
Dinner?
Didn't have dinner. We ordered pizza. Wasn't good. Wasn't good.
Where'd you order pizza from?
Lucifer's.
You don't like Lucifer's.
I do like Lucifer's. I don't know why I went for the meat pizza, the greasy meat pizza.
Oh, especially after having the shit problem.
I just, where was my head?
I do like Lucifer's.
Lucifer's is good.
Yeah.
But it wasn't a good.
That was on you.
Yeah.
That was your bad.
That was on me. And I will say that the cramps from holding my shit in were comparable to when I had an abortion in July.
No.
And it was so bad. I was like, is this, am I going through it again?
No.
Yeah. It was so bad.
Okay. I think you need more fiber in your diet.
After that, I drank a whole thing of like psyllium husk.
Okay. That's good.
Yeah. Because I was like, I can't.
Yeah. You need chlorophyll. I don't know. I hear all these people saying you need chlorophyll. You need chlorophyll.
I have chlorophyll. I don't know why I haven't been drinking it.
Because it kind of tastes like a plant. It tastes like it's good for you.
It does taste like it's good for you.
And you're like, I'm doing something good for myself.
Yeah.
But it's hard to keep up consistently with all the things that one needs to be like a healthy, fully formed person.
It really is. And then every couple years, they're like, just kidding. All of the things that we said were good for you, actually not.
Yeah. They're like, oat milk, that's actually bad for you.
Yeah. Too much sugar. Now you all have diabetes. Sorry.
Yeah. I didn't know. I'm still drinking it. Fuck
yeah.
The man.
Yeah, you think I'm going to stop?
Yeah, no.
I heard there was an E. coli. Not an E. coli. It's
bird flu in raw milk?
Yes. Yes.
That's
exactly it.
That's Robert Kennedy's big thing is raw milk.
Don't get me started.
His big thing is raw milk. Don't get me started. And I'm like, okay, cool, but I want to be able to get an abortion. Fuck your raw milk.
That's right.
And fuck your raw milk.
Fuck your raw milk. I would like an abortion. And I like an abortion. And I like the raw milk to abortion pipeline.
Yeah.
2 + 2 equals
raw milk.
Equals raw milk abortion, sweetie.
Yeah.
I know that's right.
And then I saw that, it had the avian flu in it.
And it did.
And there's all these, like, bitches on, like, influencers that are, like, they eat, like, meat organs and drink raw milk. I don't know.
So,
do you follow any of those?
Yeah, it's kind of what we tapped into with the Tradwife shit.
Oh, yeah. The Tradwife shit's... It's crazy.
And that's... Well, that's where... That's why we are where we are.
As a society?
I think so.
We're not in a good place as a society.
We're not. And I understand people's whole, like, distrust of vaccines. I understand these things. There is, like, a validity to it in doses. But then you go... But do any of you actually know anything? And I say this as somebody who doesn't know anything.
But then, and then when Elon Musk forms the department of whatever, the Doge department, I'm like, wait, he made a magical currency and now that's the name of his job?
Talk about buying the election, bitch. It's like, come on.
Yeah, it's too much. I feel like I just need to like hibernate.
And this is when you go, maybe I do become a trad wife and go live in a fucking cabin.
There is something, there is something romantic, briefly romantic, about the thought of, like, having chickens and, like rolling hills in the backyard and, like, being in, like, a really cute dress inside.
Right.
Like, I romanticize that to an extent. Baking a pie.
Yeah.
But then... The freedom to leave and be like, I gotta go do a set, talk about pussy and dick, bye.
Gotta be able to do it.
Yeah.
I wanna be able to get into my fucking car.
Yeah, like, I wanna play that role
right.
Casually.
And you see, and it's like, then you see, like, beautiful pictures of Italy, you know, like, the south of France, and you're like, wow, this is amazing. Like, these farm people living off the land. But then you go, but it's not realistic in LA, and unfortunately, we're gonna stay here.
But it's like, but are we gonna stay here?
Well, I I'm not fucking going nowhere, dude. Unless
there's like the thought of going to Europe is romantic too.
Europe
but how do you
romantic.
Survive? Like, what do? Start doing dick jokes in Prague? That's who I am now. I'm like, hey guys.
Things aren't hey, and they're like, we don't understand. We, yeah. We don't understand. I don't know what the accent is, but it's something.
Yeah.
Eastern European.
I'm in Prague. I'm walking down cobblestone streets going to my set to talk about my tits.
Right. And then you're eating some like disgusting, like gluten free. Yeah. Because like everything there is just like natural ingredients, and you're like, this tastes bad. Everything tastes bad.
But does it taste bad or does it taste better?
No, it tastes bad because we're used to...
The sugar and the processed food.
So maybe it tastes better, but I'll never know because I'm used to sugar and salt. I want sugar and salt every day.
I know. Well, during the holidays, do you feel a sense of nostalgia mixed with sadness?
No.
You don't?
No. No.
That's so funny. I thought you were going to say yes.
No, not at all. I think I would feel that way maybe if I came from like a snowy... place,
like a romantic snowy place.
Yeah, but bitch, no. It's like I grew up in San Diego. It's like, no, I don't feel nostalgia for shit. I feel nostalgia for maybe childhood. I go,
that's what I feel.
Yeah.
Like for a childhood Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Where like you don't have to make the plans, you just show up.
Right. Right.
But then I think back about my Thanksgivings as a kid and they were weird.
They were, and they never were actually what you, when you think about it, you're like romanticizing something that never actually existed.
No, you're like, yeah, so much time has passed that you look back on it with rose-colored glasses and absolutely. You're like, and we were all together as a family. And then I'm thinking about how my cousin got her tongue pierced at 14 and showed up talking in a lisp at Thanksgiving and everyone was like, she's not okay.
Yeah, and then your uncle's like smoking meth in the bathroom. Yeah.
Exactly.
Everybody's in loveless marriages. Yeah. The dog is dying. Yeah. It's, you know, it's so many things.
I have a crazy aunt who has exotic birds.
Oh, wow.
And she used to feed, this is the last time we went to their house for Thanksgiving. Okay. She would put stuffing on her fork and then feed it to the exotic birds.
What?
And they were like rocking back and forth, like, like macaws, dude. And that was the last time we went to their house.
Because of that.
Yeah, my dad was like, absolutely not. It's disgusting.
We're not watching her feed stuffing to the macaws. Yeah. Wow. Are they still alive? Because those bitches live a long time.
Yeah, they're going to outlive her.
Absolutely. And then her kids have to inherit them.
Which they'll be gladly. You know, when the whole family's off, the whole family's off, sweetie.
Sweetie, that's true. My mom grew up with a bunch of exotic birds.
She did?
My grandfather would bring them over. He was from Egypt. He would, like, fly to Brazil and bring back all of these exotic birds.
It's so mean for the birds.
It's so fucking mean.
It's such a weird thing to have an exotic, like, beautiful, tropical-looking bird in a cage.
It's so stressful.
And they would cuss, too. They were like,
they're so unhappy. They're miserable. They're like, let me back into the damn jungle.
They rock back and forth. They're like neurotic.
They're neurotic.
Plucking out their feathers. And they're like, can you pass them the mashed potatoes? It's like, like, that was our Thanksgiving.
And now they're addicted to processed foods.
Yes.
They should be eating like worms and bugs.
I know.
And now they're eating a fucking Oreo.
Dude, my boyfriend just told me, I've been buying organic eggs. And he goes, but are they pasture raised? And I said, they're free range. And he goes, they have to be pasture raised. And I was like,
why?
And he said, because free range doesn't mean, it means that they just get feed sometimes and they're in an enclosure. Pasture raised means they get to walk around all day and they eat bugs and natural stuff.
I do like that.
And I was like, I can't keep up. I've been thinking this whole time I'm doing the right thing. I'm getting the free range eggs.
No, because then here's the next thing. And then I challenge your boyfriend to this. And then the bugs that they're eating are all filled with pesticides. And then the ground is full of pesticides. Nobody's winning.
It's all bad.
It's all bad. It's like, no, the bugs they're eating are gross. It's just not.
And then I'm like, I don't know if I want to eat a chicken that's eating a bug.
Yeah, you want to eat a chicken that's eating dead chickens. You want the chickens that are eating the ground up chickens.
A cannibal chicken?
Because that's what makes them strong.
No. A cannibal.
We're losing. I don't know what we're losing, but we're losing.
What are your thoughts about Christmas? Do you like Christmas?
Such a good question. Do I like Christmas? You know, who even, it's like in adulthood, who cares?
Oh, I care.
You care?
I vaguely care.
Really?
I think I'm nostalgic for the childhood Christmas.
Yeah. Which is probably the same as
the Thanksgiving. Yeah.
No, but it is cute as a kid. You get so many, you know, you wake up early, you go to the Christmas magical. Tree. Yeah. It's just like you get presents.
Yeah.
Now it's like, I wake up and I go, do I have a show tonight? What's going on? And then I don't have a show and then I'm pissed.
And then I'm pissed I don't have a show. But then I'm like, no, it's good. I'm having a day off. Right. That's good. Do you do that when you don't have a show? You go like this whole like spiral thought process of, oh, well, what am I supposed to do if I don't have a show? I should be working. I should be working. And then if I have a show, I'm like, I have a show.
That's and right. It's and not you have a show and you're like, I don't want to do it.
It's not until midnight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't want to go.
What is that? And then after the show, I do this every week. I go, I have a set, but it's not till midnight. And my boyfriend's like, you're going to go and you're going to have fun. And then I guess you're right. And then I go and I come back. He's like, how was it? I was like, so fun. I love stand up.
Every time.
What is that?
My boyfriend says that. He's like, you always say that you want to go to the comedy store and then you never go, but then you go and you have such a good time and you come back and you're like, yeah, I loved that. And I'm like, I know. I don't know why it's.
What is that?
I don't know.
And it's also like for the last like year, I've been traveling so much and I'm home for the next month. And I'm like, is that okay?
It's not okay. It's not okay. Oh, my God.
Are you going on the road anytime soon?
I'm in New York in December for a couple of days at West Nyack. at the before West Nyack Christmas? Improv. Before Christmas.
That's seasonal.
It's seasonal. Yeah, it'll be snowing. Cute.
I like that for you.
The road sounds glamorous, and then you're on it, and you're like, I'm in a hotel all day long.
And I'm sad.
Yeah. Said, I'm just on my phone, like, watching porn all day.
Do you watch porn a lot?
I do. When I'm on the road, yeah, because I have nothing else to do. I'm just like, I guess I'll watch porn.
What's your genre? Uh-oh. The pause said it all.
What do you think it is?
Orgies. I'm getting orgy energy from you.
Like, what kind of orgy?
Women orgy.
Not wrong. If I was going to watch an orgy, I would watch one guy and a bunch of women.
Same.
Right?
This is what Harper and I were talking about. She says she likes to watch man-on-man porn.
It's so fucked up when women are like that. I'm like, are you good?
That's what I said.
Are you good?
She said she liked to watch men fucking other men. And I go, that's my least favorite type of porn. And she was like, well, maybe you're more gay than you know. And I go, maybe.
I don't know, dude. It's like, I would barely like to watch men fuck women. Once in a while.
I know. Why?
I don't know.
It's gross to me.
It's gross to me, too.
Sometimes it's not one hot guy, though.
I'm not really paying attention.
It's a hot older guy.
Okay.
That's like my thing.
Okay.
Like old dudes.
Okay.
It's how weird. Old? Not old, but older than the...
Like geriatric?
Not geriatric.
Okay.
But like older than the person that they're fucking. Like 10 years at least.
Okay.
Yeah.
10 years.
Yeah.
I like that minimum. You can tell the difference.
Well, I wanted to look more like a...
seasoned lover.
Yeah.
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 So what are you watching?
So I will type in, like, as if I'm a 14-year-old boy, I will literally type in to the Pornhub search bar... big tits, big ass.
Big tits, big ass?
Big tits, big ass.
That's your keywords?
Big tits, big ass.
You like big tits and big ass?
Big tits, big ass. I can't watch porn with women whose bodies look like mine.
Really?
If she has no tits, I'm not watching.
See, I'm the opposite.
Really?
I like them to look kind of like me. Like,
I can't do it.
I needed her to have kind of a bush.
Really?
I prefer a bush.
I get that.
I'm like, I prefer a bush because I kind of have a bush.
Yeah.
So I like to feel like...
you're what? Yeah.
It's me.
Interesting.
is that crazy?
No, I think that's probably pretty relatable. Because when I masturbate, if I'm not watching porn, I'll think about myself having sex.
Yeah.
But if I'm watching porn, I'm not thinking...
of yourself.
No.
And I'm still thinking of myself.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Now, see, and usually, too, I'll watch Latina or Ebony porn.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I didn't see that coming.
Yeah.
That's what you're into.
Nair a white woman.
You don't like seeing a white woman.
Is the word nair? Nair a white
I know what you mean.
Seldom a white woman. Let's say that.
Nair a white woman.
Yeah. It's not
you don't
want to
see Caucasian.
I don't love to see. I mean, I won't say no, but my first thing is Ebony or Latina.
Really?
Big titty, big ass, Ebony Latina porn.
Big titty, big ass.
Yeah.
You like a big ass.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I'm going to.
Whoa.
I know.
Sometimes I watch S&M, and then I'm like, whoa, it was aggressive.
S&M, really?
Yeah.
Wow. I can't do the...
You can't.
No.
You don't like it.
No. I can't with the... when it's too rough... stresses me out.
Well, when it's too rough and the woman doesn't seem like she's enjoying it, then I'm out.
Yeah. Well, S&M is like...
They're like tied up.
No.
That's no for you.
It's a no for me. Wow. It's so interesting. I don't like... whatever fucking primal thing we're tapping into with porn, don't even know.
I don't even know either. And also like... if I'm going to masturbate, I like to watch it because my mind goes too many fucking places.
Wait.
If I don't have porn.
Okay.
I'm thinking about.
Right. Anything.
Should I be working more?
Yeah.
And it's like distracting.
It is. I get that.
Yeah.
And porn is in a way like meditative because you like just aren't thinking about anything. It's like my one time where my brain entirely is not.
Thinking.
Spinning.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm just like, oh, fat tits. Nice. You know? It's just like.
Yeah.
You're transported.
The porn that I can't stand is when the ladies pretend like they're stuck somewhere. Have you seen that?
Give me an example. Like, she, in like, a washing machine?
Yeah, or like under the bed. And she's like, I can't get out. It's like bad acting.
The acting, I know, the acting will throw you off.
I have to skip the acting.
I know. We don't need all this setup.
Do you watch the backstory?
Never.
Do you watch the whole porn straight way through, or do you skip around?
I skip around.
I skip around too.
Yeah, who's watching the whole? I'm like, why is this porn 48 minutes? What are we doing?
Sometimes I go back and rewatch ones that I like.
I'll do that.
You do?
Yeah, I'll do that. There's a couple porn stars that, like, I will revisit their
catalog.
Their catalog.
Their art.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who?
I always forget her name. Oh, I think her name is Maserati X. And she is like, she's a BBW. Oh my God, Maserati X, triple X or something.
And Maserati
X. Is that her name? Yeah, yeah, dude, I love Maserati X.
Oh, damn. We're watching different types of porn.
Look how big her tits are.
They're so big.
Yeah, dude, she's got the biggest tits.
And
she's
like, into that.
She's laying dudes out with them. Yeah, it's good.
That's like so much tit for me. I don't know if I could get past it. Wow, we like different porn.
Can't believe you're not liking Maserati X. Maserati triple X.
Maserati triple X.
That's my girl, dude.
Dude, Maserati triple X. How? So you explored her catalog.
I've explored her catalog. I haven't watched porn in a little while.
What's a little while?
Probably a couple weeks.
Okay. She's been busy.
I've been busy. I've been so busy.
Holding in your shit, seeing Wicked, getting your lips dissolved. You know, the essentials.
The essential. Yeah. Other things have gotten in the way.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Porn is wild. Dude, my friend, after her mom died, she was cleaning out her... Sorry to change subjects. She was cleaning out her mom's house, and she found porn. Like, a lot of it.
Like magazines?
Like DVD porn.
Really?
DVD porn and lubes and vibrators.
How old was her mom?
70-something.
Wow.
Isn't that... That is like...
And vibrators and... I like that she had DVDs.
She had DVDs.
Imagine, like, dude, people had to do that back then. Go to video stores.
Let's go to the sex store and get a DVD, babe.
I remember how in the Blockbusters, there was the adult section, yes, and it was always behind, like, the beaded...
Yes.
Little fucking door thing?
Yes.
Whoa. What a time.
Renting a porn. And then, like, when was the last time you went to a sex store?
I probably went pretty recently.
She's like, today.
Maybe I'll go after. I go to Pleasure Chest a lot in
Pleasure
West
Chest
Hollywood.
Is nice. It's nice. It's expensive.
It's very expensive. I drop some good coin there.
You do?
Yeah.
On vibrators?
Vibrators.
What else?
I've got a good one right now. Last time I was there, I bought a dildo, and I'm not a dildo girl, but, you know, on OnlyFans, I'm like, oh, I use a fucking dildo once in a while.
Oh, on your OnlyFans.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're doing dildo play on your
OnlyFans.
I'll
do dildo play sometimes.
You do?
When I'm like, when I really need to make some money.
Okay.
I'll do it.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, I'll buy like lingerie.
Lingerie is expensive.
Lingerie is so expensive.
It's annoying.
And I don't really know what the point of it is. And it's like, I'll take pictures in it. And I'm like, oh, the only place that this can go, obviously, is OnlyFans.
I had like this phase where I was like very into like costume, like sex costumes. Like I have a nurse. I have a maid. I have
fun. Wait, would you have sex in these costumes?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Did you like that?
Yes.
I can see that being very fun.
Very fun.
What? Yeah. Wait, would you like... role play, like,
yeah,
really?
Like in a different costume. Yeah,
see, okay, I can't do that because I get too...
It depends on who you're doing it with. Really? Like the person that, like... I would do it with was like really into it and good at it too.
Okay.
So it was easier to stay in the scene.
It's so hard,
you know what I mean?
Yes.
Because it's like, it's hard to take yourself seriously as a nurse if the other person's laughing, like,
yeah. Like, dude, it's so hard to... It's like the same, it's kind of the same thing to me as like why I don't want to be an actor, because it's so embarrassing having to be like, pretend that you're somebody else, you know? Like, do you want me to check your pulse?
Yeah.
Oh, what's this? A big boner? Do you need help with this? But like, if you can get into it.
The maid was fun.
What would you do as the maid?
I would come in like clean And then
what, he was like laying on the bed and you're
No. And then he knew I was going to be dressed up as a maid. So then he would leave things in the bed for me to find. Like as the maid, like a vibrator. Like he'd be like, I'm sorry, plates. I didn't mean to leave that out.
Okay.
Like stuff like that.
Yeah. He left the vibrator out.
Yeah. He's like, sorry, that's so embarrassing. I meant to put that away before you came over to clean. Like,
sorry, I've been putting this on my asshole. Yeah. Oopsies.
Stuff like that.
Wow.
Yeah. But then I would wear the costume once and then I'm like, now what do I do with it?
We've already done it. We've already.
Yeah. Yeah. So now in a chest I have, I got a nurse. I got a maid. I got a schoolgirl. I have a, you name it.
You've got them all.
I collect them all like Pokemon.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. That's one that I've always wanted to explore, but I'm just too in my head. The only time I think that I've ever really, I think I took. Okay, was it Ativan? I don't know. It was something I took.
Like a Xanax, Ativan?
Sort of like it was something, and I took it for a long flight to pass out.
Okay.
And the thing about whatever it was that I took, maybe it wasn't Ativan. If you stay up, if you don't fall asleep, you start hallucinating.
Yeah.
And so I was in Italy with my ex-boyfriend, and I took whatever it was. And I remember, I have scattered memory of this because I was like blackout on this like Ativan.
Yeah.
And I got really, he said that I got like really into role play and I don't really remember.
No.
But I from what I remember, I was saying things like, shh, we can't tell your coworkers we're in here having sex.
No.
This is our secret. And he said that I kept like swapping characters. And I'm like, where is this energy when I'm not on Ativan?
No. What do you mean?
I would like to be able to do that.
Yeah.
Without being blackout on like a sleep medication.
That's so funny.
I know.
You got into like a weird thing where you were like a psychosis.
I was in a psychosis. I was in a role play psychosis. I was doing whatever it is that you do in all of your costumes. You're so lucky you can do that.
I haven't been doing it with my boyfriend.
He's not into...
I just like... Because it's like kind of scary to like introduce it.
Again. It is scary. It's like embarrassing.
I could. I could like put on the outfit. He'd be down.
Okay. What? Yeah, I guess I... Good.
Yeah.
Because it is... It's so... Dude...
Putting on lingerie is already a little scary.
It's embarrassing. It's like so vulnerable. And I buy this stuff and I'm like, how am I going to introduce this... In the bedroom. Like, when am I just going
to
be...
Sometimes I just go to the bathroom and then I just come out in it.
Yeah, wow.
Do you do that?
No.
No.
No. I don't. It's like, I am always looking so disgusting when I have sex. Because it's like, you know, when you're like going to bed and you're wearing some like disgusting oversized t-shirt and some like period stained underwear.
Yeah.
Like, my makeup's off. I just popped all my pimples. Like, I look so gross.
Yeah.
And then you just are like, well, I guess we're both here. We'll just have sex.
Yeah.
There's... Nary a day when I have.
This is the word she's been using.
Yeah, it keeps being nary.
Nary a day.
Nary a day. Dude, there's like hardly ever a time when I have like sex when I look hot.
Really?
Know? Never. Hardly.
I mean, I did. The last time I had sex, I looked horrible. I can't.
Why?
I just looked like I had like my makeup from the night before underneath my eyes. I like woke up and I was like, he's going to want to have sex, but I at least have to brush my teeth. I like made myself brush my teeth.
That too.
And then I came back to bed and I felt like so like, you know, when you're just at home and you're planning on seeing no one.
Yes.
That was the vibe.
Right. Just like kind of crusty and dirty.
Yeah.
Yeah. I know. And it, like, again, like introducing fucking lingerie and stuff, it's just so vulnerable. I don't know how to.
What if you
even
give him lingerie like in a gift bag that you put on
and then he tries it on?
No, and then you're like, this is your gift, but I'm gonna wear it. Is that weird?
I don't think that's weird, but then it's like, do I put it on right there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I have to make sure that I look hot before I put on.
You have to pre-try it on. You have to have a dress rehearsal.
Right. I have to have a dress rehearsal.
You have to have it. I would have dress rehearsals.
You really?
Yes. I have to know what it looks like before I go and wear it for somebody else.
Would you? Okay. So with like your nurse costumes,
yeah.
Would you like have something that you knew you were going to say?
No.
Okay. So it was all improv.
It was all improv.
Whoa.
Yeah. We leave it to the moment.
Yeah. It's very, you're in a yes and with
a
that.
Yes and. Yeah. But it also depends on the person that you're having sex with. You know what I mean? Like, some guys are really into that and they're easy to do that with. And other guys, it's like they're into other things.
Yeah, they're not so open to it's so.
It's like you just don't know.
Yeah.
You know?
You don't.
And sometimes people, sometimes when I've hooked up with people, they do something and I'm like, well, I'm not into that. Has that happened to you?
Yes.
Like what?
Okay. The first thing that comes to mind is this guy that I dated very briefly. He would eat his cum.
What?
Hmm.
What do you mean?
So he would come. He would come.
And then
eat it. And when I saw that, I was like, I'm sorry, what? And he was like, you're making me feel weird. And I was like,
no.
Yeah. He's like, you're making me feel really judged. And I was like, I'm sorry. I've just never seen anybody eat their cum before.
No.
What the hell?
Every time?
Yeah. It's like, and after that, you just get used to it. You go, and I'm so codependent. You know, I'm such a people pleaser. I was like,
Do you want a spoon for that?
Literally. Yeah. Do you want me to get some pepper? Would it be good with some ingredients too?
No.
Like, that was a weird one.
That is a weird one.
Yeah, it's a weird one. But also more common than you think.
Cum eaters.
Yes. Because I've talked about it. And then I've heard other women be like, oh, yeah, I've dated guys who have done that. And I'm like,
I've never hooked up with a guy who's done that.
He's the only
one.
And
I've tasted the rainbow.
Yeah, I mean, I like the wing.
Yeah.
I have as well. He was the only one.
One time I was hooking up with this guy and like out of nowhere he called me a bitch, but the way he did it was like weird and I did not like it. And he said it like really kind of like, he didn't even do it like in a dominating way. He did it in like a submissive way.
Really?
Like, you're a bitch. And I was like, no, you're a bitch. Like,
yeah, you're like, no, fuck you, pussy.
Yeah, like, it just was like, it took me completely out of it. I was like, no, I don't want to be like degraded and called a bitch.
I don't like being degraded either.
I don't want to be called a bitch.
What about slut?
That's different.
Do you like being called slut?
If it's like from my boyfriend. Yeah.
Really? Yeah. I'm still not used to that. My boyfriend is into that. And I'm still like, I don't ever say like, don't call me that. But when he says it, I have to like,
it's like,
I have to go, okay. That one
you don't love.
I don't love being called a little slut. I don't know what it is about it.
See, I don't mind that, but I do mind being called a bitch.
Yeah, but especially when it's like submissive sounding.
Yeah.
That's like, crazy.
If you're going to call me a bitch, you got to be dominant. You can't be like, bitch. I'm like, I'm sorry. Yeah. Are we girlfriends in a fight?
Yeah, his voice is quivering.
Yeah.
Bitch.
It was not good.
It sounded like he was trying it on you to see.
Yeah, like he wasn't even confident in saying
it. Yeah, he was like, I've never said this before. I got to get out of my system.
Like, bitch. It felt like it was like an intrusive thought.
That's crazy.
Because it just came out of nowhere.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, sex is so interesting.
It is.
And it's funny that as women, you know, as women comics, when people are like, all women do is talk about sex. And I always think I'm like, because it's such a weird experience as a woman to have sex with a man. And it's so funny and it's so vulnerable and it's like so human. It's like such a weird thing.
Yeah, it's like part of life.
It's a part of life and something that like we are still very ashamed to talk about because it's also so awkward. Like sex is so awkward. That's why I think it's so
That's
easy.
Why I like being in a relationship.
Yeah.
Because you're like, okay, it's less awkward.
It's less awkward.
Yeah.
And I think that's why it is easy to get like addicted to porn because it isn't like you're actually dealing with like the awkwardness of real life sexual interaction.
Like, if you saw Maserati XXX in real life, I don't know if you'd be able to handle it.
Absolutely not. I wouldn't be able to fuck her. Jesus Christ.
It's too much woman.
It's too much woman. But, you know, you slip into fantasy land and you're like, this is easy and I don't have to, like, deal with any of it.
Yeah.
Sex is so interesting.
It is interesting. And it's also, like, I don't know. And you never know what people are going to be into. Like, I didn't know you were going to be into Maserati XXX.
You had no idea. I didn't know that you were going to have a drawer full of costumes.
Well, when you got the costumes, you talk about the costumes, sweetie.
You got to do it. You got to tap into the character.
You got to break through. It helps with your performance on stage. It if you sure can become does. A maid for a little bit.
Well, you know what's so interesting to me too is like, how do people discover what they're into? Like, you have, you know, worlds of fetishes. Like, what are the ones that dress up as like animals? Furries.
Oh, that's...
How do you realize you're into that and then find other people that are into that? Like, how?
Well, there's people that go to sex parties. I've never been to a sex party. Have you?
I know, but I would like to go to one. No, I sort of went to one.
What happened?
It was so bad. I went expecting it to be, it was like a Renaissance, no. quote unquote, sex party. No. So I went being no. like, oh, it's going to be like a bunch of like horny dorks, blah, blah, blah. It was so lame. You didn't see anybody. There were people walking around with like their tits out.
Okay.
Which was like, oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
But the sex was like in a room that you weren't allowed to go in. Like.
Unless you were having it?
Yeah. And it like, I want to go to a sex party where I walk in and I see everybody having sex.
Yeah.
Where it's just like, whoa. But it wasn't like that.
Was it in L.A.?
It was. It was, like, in downtown.
A Renaissance-themed sex? Where it was, like, people dressed as, like, wenches yes. getting fucked?
And you could throw nah. tomatoes at them with their head in, like, a
no.
thing.
No, are you lying?
No, I swear to God. There was a woman, like, with her head
with
in...
With a guillotine?
Yeah.
A sex party where there's a woman with her head, like, getting in fake shackles. Beheaded?
And she wasn't getting beheaded. It was, like...
I get what you mean. Restrained.
Yes. And you could throw tomatoes at her.
Gabby,
yeah.
what the fuck are you talking about?
It was not.
You could
it wasn't what I thought it was.
You could throw tomatoes. That's a nightmare. Right? Imagine you getting tomatoes thrown at you. That's like bombing as a comic in like a movie.
Yeah, but you're naked.
But you're
but
naked.
Your tits are out. Yeah.
And were they into getting tomatoes thrown
yes,
at them?
Yeah. No, it's like people who love being degraded. They'd love it.
Have you seen someone get tomatoes thrown at them?
Not that exact thing, but I've heard of these parties. And
stuff. Yeah, they're bizarre.
Yeah.
And I went thinking it was going to be something else, and then it was not actually what it...
Were you in costume?
No, I wasn't.
You weren't even in costume?
I wasn't even in costume, and honestly, I'm glad I wasn't, because it wasn't even worth dressing up for. It was like...
Were the people attractive?
No, and that was the other thing. None of them were attractive.
That's what I think. That's what I think about sex parties. I think it's just whatever, who's ever left over trying to get it in.
It's literally, it's gutter people.
On that Saturday.
It is. It's gutter people. They crawl out of the gutters and they're like, we all got to go fuck.
Oh.
Yeah.
And like, did they have to get STD checked before?
At the party I was at? Hell no.
No.
No. I can't imagine any of those people did. It wasn't like a hot Hollywood sex party. It was, something from hell. It was something from hell.
It was? When was it?
Very honestly, recently, like 4 months ago, maybe.
Did you go with your boyfriend?
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, I did.
What did he think?
He was like, what the hell was that? What the hell was that?
How did you get invited?
A mutual friend. He was like, I'm going to the sex party tonight. And so a group of friends and I went.
Okay.
And it just wasn't.
Did any of your friends like hook up with strangers?
Nobody hooked up with strangers. You didn't want to hook up with
strangers.
You guys
were like huddled together in the corner, like awkward.
Yeah. We were like walking around. It wasn't hot. And then the room where people were having sex, you couldn't get in there unless you had like, you paid an extra $45 and had a bracelet to go in there. And there were like four ugly people in there having sex.
You could see, peek in and see.
My friends went in there, they like somehow finagled a way to just go in there, and then as soon as they got in there, they got kicked out because they didn't have the bracelets. Yeah, and they were like, you didn't miss out.
Oh,
and I was like, damn,
that's wild.
I know,
this has been a wild episode. We really covered a lot.
If you have any sex parties you hear about, take me with you. I'm dying to go to one.
You're dying to go to one?
And not to fuck people, I just want to see what's going on.
For observation?
Absolutely. Leave the tomatoes at home.
I don't get invited to sex parties. Xavier, do you?
I got invited to one this year and I didn't want to go.
Why didn't you want to go?
Just going like alone felt weird. Like, cause
that's true.
I didn't want to just be like, oh, hey guys, and then like everybody brought someone. I'd be like, oh.
Yeah, that's true. Especially as a guy, you don't want to be like the guy that shows up alone.
Yeah, like, oh, I came to enjoy yours, man.
Yeah.
The cuck at the sex party.
Literally the cuck. Yeah. I really don't. There's a whole kink world. I want to know more about it, but I'm just not in that world.
Up in the Bay, I've seen some too where like you have to like Skype. You have to do like a Skype interview, and they want to like look at you.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe you should go to something like that so you make sure there's not a bunch of uggos just walking around.
Yeah, I've heard of ones like that too, where it's like invite only, and you have to. Yeah.
I would love to go. Imagine getting rejected.
I'm sure you're gonna get. I'm sure after this podcast, people will invite you to sex parties.
You guys, please invite me to the sex party. But okay, literally, how embarrassing would it be if you had a Zoom call and they were like,
Okay, can you do a 360 turnaround?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a no from us, dog.
We're so sorry. There's a ugly Renaissance one down the street, though.
You like tomatoes?
Yeah.
That's our podcast. And that's our podcast.
I just could keep going. You know?
Where can people find you?
You can find me on Instagram.com, Gabby Lamby, GABBYLAMBY. And that's, I guess, where you can find me.
Gabby Lamby.
And you can find you.
At Princess Shank on Instagram. And you can find me here every Wednesday on Shank, every Monday on This Bitch. This comes out the 4th. So on the 12th, we're doing a show at the Comedy Store. It's a fire lineup. It's me, Kim Congdon, Whitney Cummings, Jordan Jensen, Ian Fidance, and Josh Potter.
So good.
It's going to be fun.
What day is that?
The 12th. 12-12.
Oh my God, I'll be in town. I have to go.
Yeah, you got to go.
I have to go.
It's going
to
be so fun. And patreon.com/SarahWeinschenk for bonus content. And we'll see you next week. Bye.